Satnam. I wanted to talk a little bit about our life cycles and the cycles that we go through as we are little and as we get older, and how these life cycles really can help us and how we can be available and open for them. And I know a lot for people my age right now, I'm 32 years old, we're transitioning into a life cycle which is 33 years old, and we're going through a lot of major changes, or we're trying to find out what we need to do, what we're going to do for our lives. And for the ones that are like around 28 and between that age and 30, that's another, that's when Saturn return comes back into your sign. So that's really big time bomb, and it's good for us to be aware that these things are happening and why we're shifting and why things are happening in our lives. So there's time cycles, and there is the 7-year life cycle, which is considered the year, the cycle of consciousness. I'm just gonna read to you a little bit. And this happens every 7 years. So it's, you know, from when you were born to 7, and then 14, 21, 28, and so on. It says, changes the basic level and style of consciousness. How do we interpret things? What are our priorities? What are our values? How do we find and create meaning? To what depth, quality, and character are we aware our original self? What is our scope of being? How connected are we to people and the universe? So this happens every 7 years, that we go through this really shifts in our consciousness where we're trying to connect. And you know, if you're going through your Saturn return, this is when Saturn comes back into your sign, and happens every 30 years, and you start feeling the transition between 28 and 30. And that's when Saturn is really a planet of learning and teaching, and it's pushing you to do things, is making you look at your shadow. And that's why a lot of people, when they go through the Saturn return, you know, they move to different cities, they get a different job, they do a lot of different things, because Saturn is pushing them. I know that for me, when I was going through Saturn return, I did my spiritual practitioner. That's when I started doing my spiritual practitioner studies. This is when I started my Kundalini yoga journey, and this is when I was really trying to, you know, doing all these things, because Saturn was pushing me to do all these things spiritually, and it was really an awakening time. But it was really, some can define it as a struggle if you're not aware that you're going through Saturn return. So that's why I want to explain to you a little bit of the cycle, so you get an idea. When you're going through something, okay, you can say, oh, I'm going through this life cycle. How can I allow this to be a time of awareness and consciousness, and not get caught up in the drama, in the darkness, in the shadow, but really see the shadow as a way of really diving deep into your consciousness and really start attracting what you desire. Because we're meant to be here. We're meant to be abundant, because we are abundant. Our true nature is abundance. So when we're struggling with these life cycles, we're struggling with our divine essence, because our essence is, it's doing, it's being, but we need to be in the flow, allowing it to happen. So instead of seeing these cycles as a struggle, we can see them as blessings in our lives that are going to push us to do more, to give us courage, to give us strength, to keep going. So and then there's the 11-year cycle, which happens every 11 years. And this is the cycle of intelligence. So the 7-year cycle is the consciousness, and the 11-year cycle is the cycle of intelligence. Changes our applied intelligence. How do we manifest our thoughts into action? What are the strategies we pursue towards realizing our goals? How do we enact our consciousness? How does our spirit and our consciousness guide you to like to act intuitively? How well do we perceive cause and effect and the applications of our actions and choices? So this happens when you're 11, 22, 33, 44, 55, and so on. So around the age of 33, which I'm going to be entering one of my life cycles, a cycle of intelligence, and the 7-year cycle, which is when you're 28 and then when you're 35. So you see people struggling around these times when they're 33, and then you have the cycle of the 18 years, which is 36. So 33, 34, 35, 36. These are really major life cycles are going to happen in your life. And the transitions towards them it could be a little burden because you could be a little confused of what is happening to me. What am I going through? What do I want? How can I accomplish things? How can I manifest what I'm thinking into reality? So I really invite you that if you are going through these cycles right now, that you really start by acknowledging what you're going through. I think this is like where your life purpose starts setting in motion. This is where you can start making decisions about what you're going to do and how you're going to pursue them. Is it going back to school, maybe? Is it actually, looking for a different job that's actually going to align with what you want to do? And this is a major cycle because we're just trying to figure out how we're going to manifest our thoughts into our experience. So I would start by writing them down and really just being aware and meditating of and being conscious of what we're thinking and what we're thinking, because we want to be sure that we're aligning ourselves with our purpose. And this is a time that if you don't know your life purpose, you know, start looking at what you've been attracted to since you were little. Start, writing down what is it that, you know, moves you, because these times are going to be the times that are going to push you and push you. And then you have the 18-year cycle, which is called the life energy. This changes physical health and vitality and our manner of dealing with our life, our interactions, level of activity, needs for quality of life, lifestyle and habit to care for our physical well-being. And this is every 18 years, so 18, 36, 54, 72, and so on. So the reason I wanted to just show you a little bit of these cycles is because I want you to be aware that these cycles are there. You know, and Saturn return comes back to your sign every 30 years. So it comes when you're 30, and then comes back when you're 60, and so on. They're pushing us. And when you are confused, when you don't know what's going on, it's good to really, you know, find an astrologer or find someone spiritually that can guide you to. So, because when you're guided, then you can maneuver these obstacles much easier, and then you can truly live a life just flowing with the divine. Because when you flow and you let go, the divine truly, truly takes care of you. The universe has your back, and these obstacles, these cycles, these whatever you want to call them, are there to guide us, to help us be in alignment with the divine. Because, you know, you need a little push, you need a little struggle in order for you to start actually being in that place of abundance and prosperity and joy and happiness. I mean, you don't appreciate abundance until you don't have it. You don't appreciate other things until it's no longer there. So it's for us to be pushed so we can see the beauty and be grateful. So that's why I invite you each moment, like, don't allow yourself to be in a place of fearful thoughts. Be in a place of love, be in a place of abundance. And if you're not feeling like yourself, go do something that is going to align you, like take a bath, you know, a hot bath with essential oils. Go dive into the ocean if you have the ocean near you. Go into your pool if you have a pool near you. Go for a nature walk. Do things that are going to align you so you feel better. Don't rely on alcohol and other kind of addictions or going out or partying. Don't rely on that. Rely on your higher self to cleanse you and have the courage to be in this essence of love, of beauty, of joy, of happiness with what you're meant to be, because your life purpose is to be a walking God, you know, walking that essence of what the divine is, because you are divine. And I'm going to keep repeating this to you till you tell me one day, yes, I'm Shakti. I do remember that I am divine and I am the walking essence of what God is. So I hope this little video helped you. Let me know in the comments and just let me know. Sat down.